बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे वी हैव टू डिस्कस क्रिटिकल डिस्कोर्स एनालिसिस एंड द मॉडल ऑफ वैन डाइक। सो व्हाट वैन डाइक सेज अबाउट क्रिटिकल डिस्कोर्स एनालिसिस। वैन डाइक इज अ स्कॉलर ऑफ टेक्स्ट लैंग्विस्टिक्स। Text linguistics is a branch of linguistics that deals with text communication system and its original aim lay in uncovering and describing text grammar, that how the text of the language works and how it works in a society, how it differs from one society to another one. So it is related to critical discourse analysis. So the critical discourse analysis model of Venn Dyck is it is known as cognitive model of Venn Dyck. So his approach is known as sociocognitive approach. Sociocognitive approach is a model in which the link between text and society is mediated by cognition. So cognition means that the mental level, the thinking capability, the memory of a person individually or a group of people in a society. So you know that in a society, that whatsoever we produce, what kind of discourse we produce in a society, so that is existed in our mind, in our cognition, and that cognition is the result of our social textual experience. So it has been taken from the society, from the social norms, values, and so on. So that's why he says that it is mediated. So what is mediated? Text and society. So what is existed in a society? The discourse is existent in the society. So this is mediated by or cognition, by the cognition of an individual or a group of people. So according to Venn Dyck, textual structure and social structure are mediated by social cognition. So textual structure, what is the structure of the text and what is the structure of the society? So this is totally mediated by the cognition, the mentality, the memory of a person, and it is the affected by these two things. So if we exclude the cognition of someone, and so it doesn't work with the society. I am talking about discourse. So for discourse, this is the triangle that is known as textual structure and social structure, and these two things are mediated by social cognition of a person or a group of people. So social cognition approach, social cognition, cognitive approach is defined as the system of mental representation and process of group. Sociocognitive approach is a model in which the link between text and society is mediated by cognition, and according to Venn Dyck, textual structure and social structure are mediated by social cognition. So when we talk about social cognition, so we have to talk about these three things. So the first one is that it is related to discourse. Discourse refer to a communicative event including conversational interaction, written text, as well as associated with gesture, face work, and images. So all these things are from the society by social structure with the textual structure, and there is a mediation. Mediation is known as cognition. That cognition, social cognition, is very important in discourse, in critical discourse analysis. So when we have to do analysis of a discourse, so we have to keep in mind three things. The first thing is social textual structure, and the second is social structure, and the third one is social cognition. And social cognition is the result of social experience. So what is social experience? So cognitive approach is the process in the mental that is known as mental process when discourse is production or discourse is discourse consumption is taking place in the cognition of individual or in cognition of society. So this is taking place that if it is going on in a society, why? Every society has some values, some norms, some beliefs, and that beliefs, norms are followed by an individual person or a group of people, and so that cognition is a mediator. So the mediator is very important. Cognition is very important. Why? Because it links two things. The first thing is textual structure, and the second thing is social structure. So firstly, we have to know about cognition. What is cognition? Cognition refers to personal as well as social cognition, beliefs, representations, mental or memory structures. So there's structure that are exist in our memory, in our mind. So it is the lecture, it is the production, it is it has been pursued from the society by a person. So the second thing is society. Society refers to both the local macro structure of situated face-to-face interaction as well as more global societal and political structure defined in the term of groups. So when we talk about society, so we have two kinds of memory. So the first thing is short memory and the second is long memory. Short memory, so that is existed in our cognition, so it is for very short time, and long-term memory, that is for long-term time. So that is for long time. So social schema theory, that is pursued, that is received a person from the society. So according to Van Dyck, social cognition is a social schema theory. It is socially shared mental structure and representation. So what is mental structure? Mental structure is this is a kind of picture, this is a kind of experience that is in form of concrete, in form of abstract. So this is totally based on societal experience. So although it is embodied in the mind of individual, social cognition are social. So because they are shared and presupposed by group of member in their society. So previously I talked about memory. Memory does not only the ability to remember, but also memory in the form of opinion, ideologies, representation and concepts. So all these things are part of memory, and all these things we get from the society. So firstly, there in the society text is existed, and then there is a social structure, and then there is a mental capability of a person, of an individual or a group of people. So according to Van Dyck, cognitive process and representation are defined relative to mental structure called memory. So in memory, when we talk about memory, short-term memory and long-term memory. Short-term, you know, like sometimes we do something, we follow some rules and norms, but it is for very short time and we forget it. And then like some kind of practices, social practices, so we have to do, we have to follow in our society daily, and that kind of thing that are existed in our mind, in our cognition very freshly and all the time. So cognitive process such as thinking, perceiving, knowing, believing, understanding, interpreting, language, language use, interaction, planning, hoping, feeling, etc. So all these things takes place in the mind or the memory of individual or social actors as member of social group or communication. So it is Van Dyck, he says that if discourse analysis, it is going on, the discourse is going on in a society, so as usually it is always live in a society, so we have to focus three things. So the first thing is that is known textual structure. What is the structure of the text? That how people produce a kind of structure in the text in the form of spoken or written. And then we have social structure. So whatsoever we produce in a society, so the structure has been given and it has been embodied by a society. And all these things circle around the cognition of a person, a group of person, group of people or individual person. So this is the model of Venn diagram that is circles around three things, and it has been shown in this picture that this is the triangle. That the first thing is discourse, and this is society. What is discourse? Discourse is textual structure. And then we have society, and the third one is cognition. So the role of cognition is mediator. So it links these two things. What kind of two things? Discourse and society. So the role of cognition, the role of a person individually or collectively, it is very important. And this is the model of Venn diagram.